Hello everyone. In the previous post, we discussed the analogy of cutting a log with an axe to build intuition around how axes can be used for two-dimensional arrays. However, this technique won't work when you consider a three-dimensional or a four-dimensional array. This video aims at solving the confusion on how the axis function works for a three-dimensional array. So let's get started. The way to understand the axis of a NumPy array is to collapse the specified axis. Don't be scared by the term collapse. We'll go over a simple example to show how it works. Firstly, I've created an array of 24 elements, values ranging from 0 to 23. I have reshaped it to 2 cross 3 cross 4. Picturing a high-dimensional array is a bit complex. One intuitive way to think about an array shape is to simply read it from left to right. Thus, in our case, our array can be thought of a container of 2 3 cross 4 grids, where each grid has 3 rows and 4 columns. So let's start with first axis equal to 0. So in axis equal to 0, it's defined by indexing the first element of the array. Thus, we can split the third array, a three-dimensional array, into two-dimensional arrays when considering the first axis, that is axis equal to 0. So if I consider array of 0, it gives me the first grid consisting of three rows and four columns. Similarly, when I say array of 1, it would give me the second grid consisting of three rows and four columns. Now when we add the two arrays, we get a 2D array, which turns out to be the same when we use the NumPy sum function and axis equal to 0. So if you notice carefully, originally we had a three-dimensional array of shape 2 cross 3 cross 4. After summing, we have a 2D array of shape 3 cross 4, that is 3 rows and 4 columns. So we lost the first axis, that is 2, and retained the remaining 2, that is 3 cross 4. So this is what we mean by collapsing the axis. When I say I'm collapsing the second axis or third axis, that term wouldn't appear after a function has been applied on it. Now let's look at axis equal to 1. This time we'll keep the first axis as it is, that is axis equal to 0, and sum along the second axis, which is axis equal to 1. Consider that we have 3 rows in the grid. So we consider the 6 elements, array of 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 1, 0, 1, 1, and 1, 2. This is what we get. We get an array of 4 elements each. For summing based on rows, we'll have 6 unique values as shown in the previous diagram. When collapsing based on axis equal to 1, we add generally the varying terms of the axis, that is the axis equal to 1, and the constant axis, which in our case was the previous axis, which is axis equal to 0. First row of our output, if you now have an intuition built that if we want to drop the second axis, which is axis equal to 1, that means our final array would be a 2 cross 4 array, which is 2 rows and 4 columns, so that the first row would turn out as a result of the sum of array of 0th grid 0th row and 0th grid first row and 0th grid second row. Similarly, second row of a transformation function when we apply axis equal to 1 would be a sum of first grid 0th row, first grid first row and first grid second row. Once we combine the outputs, we get a 2 cross 4 matrix, which is 2 rows and 4 columns as seen in the figure. And then when we apply an np.sum function, this is the exact result that we get. Again, if you notice, the shape of the matrix is 2 cross 4, which shows that we got rid of the second axis 3 from the original 2 cross 3 cross 4. For the final axis, which is axis equal to 2, we do the same thing that we have done so far. This time we sum along axis equal to 2 by keeping the first two axes fixed. If your intuition is clear enough now, you would realize that the final output when you apply axis equal to 2 in our case would result in an array whose shape would be 2 rows and 3 columns. The first row would be calculated using the sum as shown in the given diagram, wherein the first element of the first row would be R of 000 plus 001 plus 002 plus 003, considering all the varying elements of my second axis, keeping my first two axes constant. Similar goes for the second element in my first row and the third element in my first row, which is 38. And we'll get two rows and three columns, as would my np dot sum when we have axis equal to 2. Again, if you notice, the shape of the sum array is 2 cross 3, where we lose the last axis 2, which had a shape of 4 in our case. Hope this video demystifies how the axis function works for an n-dimensional NumPy array. Thank you so very much for watching the video. Do subscribe to the channel to enjoy more such amazing videos.